So let us discuss about the basic digital signal processing architecture. So one of the biggest bottlenecks in executing DSP algorithms is it requires a faster transformation of data to and from the memory. The data here implies the samples from the input signal, then the filter coefficients, and as well as the program instructions that are needed to perform this particular MAC operations are all coming under the data. For example, suppose we need to multiply just two numbers that reside somewhere in the memory. In order to do this, we need three binary values to be fetched from the memory. The two binary values relate to the input samples and the filter coefficient data. And the third value relate to the program instruction, which specifies what has to be done on that particular data. For example, for a multiply, we need to fetch a data program related to the program instruction multiply. If you want to perform add operation, we need to fetch the data from program memory which pertains to the add instruction. So, movement of data is very much crucial in a DSP processor architecture. So, based on that, the conventional architecture which was first used was von Neumann architecture after the brilliant mathematician John von Neumann. So in von Neumann architecture, it is very much evident that the CPU has to communicate only with just one memory, and this memory is used to store both data as well as instruction. Or we can tell that data memory and program memory are the same for von Neumann architecture. So, in order to multiply two numbers, we require at least three clock cycles. One for fetching data, one for fetching the program instruction, and the third one for performing the operation and storing the resultant into the CPU. So, this von Neumann architecture is quite satisfactory when all of the tasks are to be executed in serial. But however, in practical days, we do not go for any serial execution of tasks, and we go for parallel execution of tasks so that data can be executed in parallel. Hence, we go for an architecture called as Harvard architecture, which is needed when very fast processing is required and we are willing to pay the price for the increased complexity. So, based on this, a work was done at Harvard University in 1940s under the leadership of Howard Eikon, and he developed an architecture where we have both separate memories for instructions called as program memory and separate memory for data which is called as data memory. So as shown in this illustration, Eikon insisted on separate memories and the buses operate independently. Program instruction and data can be fetched at the same time. Thereby, parallelly execution can be done and it improves the speed over a single bus design. So, we have a separate dedicated bus, data bus for program memory and separate dedicated bus for data memory. So, most present day DSPs use this dual bus architecture. A more advanced architecture over Harvard is Super Harvard architecture, which comes with extra features such as the instruction cache memory and the I/O controller. As we know, cache is a memory concept which is used to speed up the process. And hence, in order to still increase the speed, we go for this instruction cache. The term was coined by Analog Devices to describe the internal operation of the ADSP210X6 series of digital signal processor. These are called as SHARC DSPs, a contraction of the longer term Super Harvard architecture. So this Super Harvard architecture is in general given as SHARC at DSPs. So the idea was to build upon the Harvard architecture by adding features to improve the throughput. So while the SHARC DSPs are optimized in dozen ways, There are many ways in which Super Harvard architecture is enhanced over architecture, but the major one is with respect to the instruction cache and the I/O controller. So the instruction cache improves the performance of the hardware architecture, as we have seen earlier, When two members are multiplied, two binary values must be passed over the data memory bus, while one binary value is passed over the program memory bus. To improve upon this, we start by relocating part of the data to program memory, because while fetching the data memory, we have to do two. So in order to make it efficient, part of it is allocated to the program memory. For instance, we might place a filter coefficient in program memory while keeping the input signal in data memory. This relocated data is called as secondary data. However, DSP algorithm generally must spend most of the time execution in loops such as instruction. This means that the same set of program instructions will continuously pass from the program memory to the CPU. And hence, to make utilization of this particular program memory, we allocate part of the data memory to the program memory. Thank you.